When you travel, don't you just want to hop on in one of these tour buses, but you're not sure if it's worth your money? Don't worry, we will rate these tour buses for you.
Good about y'all. If at some point you decide this gorgeous view that you're missing up here, you just can't take it and you got the night tour. It's wonderful for all the beautiful visuals. You're absolutely welcome to take photos and videos from right here aboard. Batista's Hole in the Wall is actually a lot more well known for the holes that are not in the wall. Back in the days when the mobsters had their dirty dealings over there, the holes of note were actually in the floorboards so that those mob types could make a quick getaway to some of the nearby hotels and avoid their enemies or the authorities rolling up on them. Not a lot of windows in that building, y'all. All right. It's just a fun one, but there is great food over there, and they will keep the table wine, white and red, flowing if you're looking for a nice place for an Italian dinner. Gratis table wine, white and red, at Batista's Hole in the Wall. Local favorite for sure. All right, so I'm gonna give you guys another heads up. We have definitely been having lots and lots of more people making their way to Vegas, all kinds of major events going on. So there's a lot of folks out to enjoy the beautiful Las Vegas Boulevard Strip just like we are tonight. At some points in the tour, we might get held up in some of this traffic, y'all. Spectacles downstairs, right tied to the very first seat that you'll see when you go up or down those stairs, my friends. We certainly appreciate you just helping to keep us, helping us out to keep the big bus nice and clean. All right, looks like we're gonna be making our way onto Las Vegas Boulevard, safe and smooth in just a moment here. So I'm gonna go ahead and introduce our fabulous driver for the evening who's gonna be keeping us rolling safe and smooth all up and down these Las Vegas Boulevard streets, you guys. Her name is Dez at the wheel tonight, and we're so lucky to have her. Beep, beep, honk, honk. She is one of the baddest in the biz, my friends, and we're real lucky to have her because she's going to keep us rolling safe, but that's okay. It's a beautiful view, I'm sure, from her little outdoor seating area. All right, now we're officially making our way onto Las Vegas Boulevard. Take a look to our right. That beautiful Tuscany, Italy-inspired hotel resort, the Bellagio, has been keeping guests visiting Vegas entertained with the 1,200 fountain dancing water show that goes on every day at the Bellagio Lake. It's not real deep, y'all, so don't plan on jumping in for a swim. It's less than about 3 feet, I believe. But you can catch that dancing water fountain show very frequently, especially once the sun has gone down. I heard the frequency increases to about every 15 minutes, so lots of chances to catch it. Of course, you can also take a stroll through the beautiful botanical gardens inside the Bellagio for some more fantastic photo ops that won't break the bank. We like free in Vegas, in case y'all hadn't figured out. Being a local as I am, I love to share those tips and tricks whenever I can. All right, it's definitely one of the best couple of blocks right here for people watching, my friends. If you haven't noticed already, you're very likely gonna see some of those beautiful ladies wearing a whole lot of nothing else but some bright colorful feathers and some sparkly sequins. In fact, I see some of them got them with lights built in tonight, and that's even more fun. As I heard, some of those ladies, some of those street performers will charge anywhere between $65-$75 for a commemorative photo with them and still be hoofing for tips on top of that. If you didn't know, my friends, Vegas is indeed a tipping town, okay? So they're not the only ones. All right, green light. So to our right, the Cromwell, originally designed in 2010. I'm sorry, not Cromwell, the Cosmopolitan, honey. Listen, Kay gets her tongue twisters tied. It's all right. The Cosmopolitan, AKA the Cosmo. Back in 2010, design company coming out of London originally planned this resort as high-rise condos. However, that plan did not quite fly. I'm sure partly due to the skyrocketing high-rise condo prices they would have had to charge. But they are now one of the only resorts on Las Vegas Boulevard that still has balconies built on the outside of their suites on the buildings that are hotel stay. Now, inside is a bit of a twisted Alice in Wonderland theme. Some real fun photo ops if you stroll through the inside of the Cosmo, guys, or any of my friends who are fans of high-heeled shoes. You might see the giant high-heeled shoes big enough to stand in to get your selfies. Or go enjoy a nice cocktail at the Chandelier Bar, easy bars that are in there. Next up on our right, we're passing the Aria and the beautiful high-end shops and crystals at the Aria. That's the kind of spot where they will be glad to greet you with a glass of champagne. Even if you're just searching for the old little trinket, a little keychain or something to treat yourself from Tiffany and Dolce and Gucci. More high-end resort stay at the Waldorf Astoria continues that beautiful glass-covered, shining, gorgeous resort theme. No casino inside there, though, at the Waldorf. But any of my friends who happen to be a bit more sensitive to a smoky environment, you might like to make your next reservation at the Park MGM coming up on our right. It is Las Vegas's only 100% smoke-free resort. And we love their Eataly food court as well, guys. A nice spot for a charcuterie board to treat yourself to some nice snacks. Italian theme, more Italian food out here. Gelato. And I heard they still have half-price deals between midnight and 4 a.m. Guys, we got the Dolby Live Arena, major events arena, with big performers like Usher doing his residency. A little further back, the T-Mobile Arena, home of the Vegas Golden Knights hockey team, and some few interesting shops in between Park MGM and New York to explore, like the Hello Kitty Cafe. Over here to our right, they're getting the live music started tonight on our replica of the Brooklyn Bridge at the New York, guys. Now, our New York is meant to be a replica of the 1940s New York skyline, complete with that Brooklyn Bridge, as well as the Big Apple roller coaster, which is meant to be a replica of the one found up there. They go having fun tonight on those loop-de-loops. The one found at Coney Island in the 1940s is that same style of roller coaster. Now, of course, we have our version of the Lady Liberty, one of the handful of world monument replicas that we do have here in Vegas. Ours is made of 100% industrial styrofoam. So if for whatever reason she were ever to be tossed into the ocean, my friends, it's true indeed, she would float. And back as well. Reminiscent of the land of far, far away, were indeed designed with some of those Disney designers in tow, my friends. Those Imagineers were brought on in the 1990s when Vegas was making an extra big push to be considered a family-friendly destination. So this is one of the spots they came up with. You can still go play carnival games in the basement at Excalibur, or check out a medieval times dinner theater show, Tournament of Kings. Well, that'll encourage you to eat with your hands like a person of the medieval times. Cheer for your favorite jouster. And, you know, cheer and celebrate with the king and queen, whoever wins, red or green team. Now, if this red light holds, I'm going to try my best to get through this story, y'all, because my favorite story about Excalibur is that it's actually the home of the largest payout in Vegas history. All right, so this was about 20-odd years back or so. There was a gentleman coming out of the Midwest. He wasn't that much of a gambler, but he had about $100 just burning a hole in his pocket. He walked into the Excalibur up to just about the very first slot machine he saw. He popped in that hundo, and in not too long at all, he saw it flashing up, all the sounds going off, all the lights flashing and flashing him, and saying, "Megabucks, megabucks, megabucks, baby, ooh-wee." I certainly wish everybody to have this kind of beginner's luck, my friends, because that gentleman walked away $39.7 million richer. Yeah. I wasn't quite of age at the time to be hanging out partying on Vegas Strip like y'all, okay? But if I was, I would have been making friends to say, "Excuse me, good sir, are you seeking a world traveling companion?" All right. We're going to talk about the Luxor, our beautiful Egyptian-themed hotel resort, which is complete with another couple of our world monument replicas, guys. Of course, our version of the pyramid is at angled at 39-degree angles on all four corners. Our version of the Sphinx is a little fresher. If you've ever seen photos of the original, he's still got his nose, has the name of a good surgeon, had a little work done to look his best for all y'all out here. Now, up at the top of our version of the pyramid, you of course see shining out our version of the, well, what we lovingly like to call our Vegas nightlight. It's also known as the Luxor Skybeam. It was actually created in collaboration with engineers from NASA to be the brightest light which can be seen from North America. And when functioning at full capacity, the light at the top of the Luxor can be seen about 10 miles into outer space. We have this gorgeous sunset behind it tonight. Little bit of crescent moon. I think that might be the Venus star. Look, get those photos, get those videos, honey. It's gorgeous, because truly, if ever the aliens do decide to land on Las Vegas Boulevard, my friends, I'm quite sure it'll be right around this area. We're basically just beaming them down, Scotty.
That's true.
Okay, here's one really fun little tidbit if the light holds. If you guys ever stay at the Luxor, try to make sure that you check in with guest services and ask them to not put you on the fourth floor. Apparently, outside the fourth floor, the only view that you're going to get is a vision of the lovely sphinxes behind. So you might want to see a nice, better view than that. All right. So next up, we're going to be passing by the Mandalay Bay. Beautiful, shining, golden buildings of Mandalay Bay and their sister resort, the Delano. They, of course, still have the House of Blues stage, putting on Carlos Santana's residency performances. He likes to bring a lot of other big name celebrities out there as his guest stars. Okay, I'm gonna keep talking about Mandalay, guys, but just to let you know, as we make this next block, it's gonna be one of those windy parts of the tour. In fact, one of the breeziest, windiest parts of the tour is gonna be the next few blocks, all right? So bundle up, hang on to any loose items, tuck everything away. Don't want you losing nothing precious over the rail of the big bus, including your precious selves. All right, so the beautiful Mandalay Bay is actually two resorts in one. A little tough to guess the theme of this resort, but the lush greenery kind of helps to give it away. It's a Polynesian theme, meant to be modeled on the Hawaiian island of Maui. If you're ever really looking to treat yourself, my friends, the top five floors of Mandalay Bay is the Four Seasons. So you're going to have a gorgeous view from up there. And it's also the home of one of the most popular penthouse suites in Las Vegas. Vegas, trying to beat the heat, catch before it gets too hot. I think we might have a couple wedding parties. And if you didn't know, up here on the big bus, we like to shout those out, my friends. Oh, yes. I see my bridal party. I got to shout them out. Hey, guys. I told you I was gonna shout them out. They're out here for some fun. You know, they didn't dress up like that out here in Vegas not to get some attention. All right, everybody's over here getting their photos, the sign, all lit up. This is, in fact, the only point in the tour, you guys. Des is giving us a slowdown. You have permission to stand to get your photos right about now. And Kay's getting her big bobblehead out the way so y'all can get those photos. Hang on tight, though. Try to hang on to something while you do. And it's lit up all red tonight, the 99 light bulbs that go around and around our fabulous original Vegas 99? Sign. Quick, it's not too bad tonight, guys. We're doing all right. So back to the lush beauty and greenery surrounding the Mandalay Bay. I love to let you guys know this, but if you ever wondered, do those beautiful palm trees actually grow naturally out here in the Nevada desert? No, indeed. Your tour guide, Kay, is here to let you know they do not. In fact, the city of Vegas can spend anywhere between $10,000 and $35,000 per palm tree, importing them from places like Hawaii and Florida and Mexico. Now listen, Kay's a little joke about that, y'all. Okay, I'm gonna go and tell it. It's corny. I got corny jokes galore on this tour. Just be prepared. To happen to live someplace tropical, that might be the perfect retirement plan, my friends. Get yourself a little palm tree farm going. Sell them on out here to Vegas. But listen, it really is nothing but a drop in the bucket to the city of Las Vegas. They are bringing in about $1.2 million in revenue per day. And of course, y'all just being out here enjoying your Vegas vacation are contributing to that. So, try to point out your favorite palm tree before we pass this part, guys. We'll see what we can do about getting a little plaque erected. You know, something with your initials and things right next to it. All right, nerdy. See it all lit up when they're filming American Ninja Warrior. It's a pretty fun one that comes through Vegas. Yes. Holy, some of those athletes, my goodness. We got equal opportunity only for the most part out here in Vegas. I know all my bachelor parties, like the one I just yelled at down by the sign, are probably gonna go check out some Thunder Down Under or even Magic Mike down in the Sahara. Going away. I don't know the exact date. Meant to represent the Emerald City of the Wizard of Oz when it first originally opened. Our friend Leo the Lion is the third largest bronze statue in the world, 40 feet high. And MGM is indeed the largest largest resorts on Las Vegas Boulevard. Nearly 7,000 rooms. It would take about, 17 and a half years or so for each of us to stay one night in every room at the MGM Grand. Good times. But we also love all the little amenities, the food court, places to grab a bite to eat that won't totally break the bank over here in front of MGM. Of course, Eminem's World is the spot to check out if you like the kind of coated candy. Now, it looks like this red light might hold, and I can try to tell y'all the story about the rivalry between Pepsi and Coke, which I know you guys already know. Pepsi and Coke have had that rivalry for decades, y'all, before most of us was even born, really. Now, when they first opened up the Coca-Cola experience, or whatever they're still trying to call it, Pepsi was not liking all the attention that they were getting, so you'll see if you look behind on the left, over at New York, New York, they did eventually put up their Pepsi-Cola sign on one of the brick buildings over there, guys. But Pepsi also did something super shady back in the day. They went around and paid off all the culinary managers at the time of all the hotel restaurants and food courts to only serve Pepsi products. So for a while, you had to go over here anyway just to get your Coca-Cola fix. It's not quite so tight as that anymore. It's not quite so bad anymore. Beer Towers, the one lit up in red and blue on the top, guys, also lovingly known as the Leaning Towers of Las Vegas. So whereas the Cosmo was not able to get those high-rise condos officially created, they managed to do it over here at the Aria, where I figured to say what theme is at the Aria. It's probably just luxury and expensiveness. That's the theme I would say at the Aria. Grown and classy and expensive. Another one that's coming up soon that's not available to visibly see yet, but pretty soon, well, not super soon, November of this year, guys, Formula One racing is returning to Las Vegas Boulevard. So this next corner we're going to pass on the right, if you took this next right for about a block or two, you would see where they're officially building the racing track and everything. And you hear these people revving their engines, these little wannabe drag racers on Las Vegas Boulevard tonight, all these cyclists, they really wish it was here already. But apparently the bouquet that they give the bride at Taco Bell Cantina Wedding Chapel is a bouquet of hot salsa packets. Oh. So that way you know she and her sweetie will be keeping their relationship spicy. Yes, I heard you. They were already picking up on the joke before I finished it. All right, y'all. Cameras up for that beautiful sign on top of the Paris, just because it's one of the best views we have of that beautiful replica of the very first hot air balloon released at the 1800s World's Fair. A little bit more, though, about the Planet Hollywood. Their main feature, the Miracle Mile Shops, is great to stroll through for unique shops and restaurants. Even a bar called the Tipsy Robot, where your cocktail will be made for you by that AI technology that's trying to come up and take over. And listen. But also, if you're a fan of those famous celebrity chefs, Gordon Ramsay's trying to take over Vegas. Also, over here to the right, he has his Gordon Ramsay Burger Restaurant. That's the red neon line with the red neon light with the arrow pointing to the right there. And I heard that they're worth it, even at a $25 to $30 price point for a burger. Yes, I've literally heard nothing but good things from any of my Big Bus guests over months and months now. So, because it's known supposedly for being the home of the strongest margaritas on Las Vegas Boulevard. You might leave there wobbling, calling it Cabo Wobble. So to the right, the beautiful Arc du Triomphe, guys, and as well, of course, emergency services. I'm gonna go ahead and hush a minute.
We're back there.
They're on Dez's left side, trying to get past. Pizza cake just underneath here. With so cake boss bringing his expertise to Vegas. Expensive real estate on Las Vegas Boulevard. Y'all will notice to the right that McDonald's can only afford one arch. Yeah, Casino Royale Resort, or gambling hall, I should say. Don't hook me up with the first 20 bucks off it. It's a tutorial as well. To the right now, our beautiful, ornately designed Venice, Italy themed resort, the Venetian. Definitely considered one of the most romantic as well. Lots of wedding parties come over here to take their photos. You could go for a run of God to love us, be sung to and serenaded in Italian, or take a stroll through the Grand Canal shops. Lots more lovely eateries and unique shops to explore. Strolling all the way through the Grand Canal shops, you could make your way to their sister hotel resort, the Palazzo, over here to our right. The wind is picking up just a little bit here, guys. Run a little for a moment there. So the Palazzo was added a few years later after the popularity, of course, of the Venetian was so high. They said, let's keep this gorgeous Italian theme going. Beautiful, ornate design, lovely to stroll through, even more great restaurants. Listen, is it dinner time? I smell them cooking. And the Palazzo is actually one of our tallest resorts currently. 73 floors over there at the Palazzo. There's somebody trying to beat that record. All right, we'll talk about that later. But now we got to talk a little bit about the Wynn. The Wynn Hotel Resort. Steve Wynn, y'all. He was indeed one of the original visionaries and main moguls responsible for modern Las Vegas Boulevard as we know it today, okay? Dreams, you have to walk through the beautiful interior of the building, enjoy that gorgeous, ornate design, to go check out the free, yes, Kay said, free show at the Wynn, the Lake of Dreams show, every evening 7 p.m. Now, we talk about the Encore and the Encore Beach Club because it was meant as an addition to the Wynn a few years later, but soon became a major hotel resort in its own right. And on their 50th wedding anniversary, Steve Wynn gifted CEO ownership of the Encore his name. Well, come back around about their next anniversary, my friends. Miss Elaine Wynn gifted Mr. Steve Wynn right on back a Wynn divorce paper. Convention center. It is indeed the world's largest convention center, and Vegas is home to over 22,000 conventions. Enjoying a nice night. On the right, we're passing Wise Guys Comedy Club, live comedy for you over there. Of course, there's lots to see, and especially if you make your way to this area again, guys. It's the very first weekend of every month of the year. This area will be even more busy and popular because there's a huge street festival known as First Fridays, and a lot of this area will actually even be cordoned off for pedestrian crossing only. You're going to see all these bright, colorful street art murals on the building. We'll be seeing even more cultural art not too long. There's some of the little vintage clothing and unique locally owned boutiques, vintage hair shop, you know, get your hair done in a little classic pinup style. We like our friends to the right at the Rebar in red, white, and blue. You guys are entitled to a free drink at the Rebar with your big bus ticket. Great food down here. here. We got Mexican at Casa de Juan, more Italian food at Esther's Kitchen on the right, Caribbean food at Jammy Land, and music over there on the right. Oh, and on this corner, and we get to the red light in a second, if any of my friends on the tour tonight happen to be fans of the pugilistic arts, over here to your left, that would namely be boxing. We got the world-famous Johnny Tacos Boxing Gym, made famous by fighters like Muhammad Ali and Mike Tyson, doing their training over there, especially in the 90s when they had big fights coming up, places like Caesar's Palace and MGM. Now on the left, it's a little tougher to see because it's dark. There's a bright, colorful building that says Love Las Vegas on it, guys. That is a huge art gallery known as the Arts Factory. Kay has to say that one real slow because when she gets tongue-tied, it sounds kind of funny. It does. It is, say that three times fast. Arts Factory, Arts Factory, Arts Factory. Okay, Farts Factory. Oh, I'm so silly. All right, but on the, okay. About the huge art gallery, it's mainly that that will be open to the public when they have the street festival down here, guys. The first Friday of every month, first weekend. So yes, but on this next corner of the tour, guys, we are coming up on a bit of a more somber part of the tour. We're coming up on our beautiful green healing space known as the Healing Memorial Gardens. It is our memorial for the unfortunate events of October 1, 2017, where there was a lone gunman that chose to break out a window over near the Mandalay Bay and to open fire on the unsuspecting crowd that was just out on a Sunday evening to enjoy a country western music festival concert that was going on. Now, we do have one tree planted for each of the precious souls that were lost that day, and that event did make a huge impact on my city. But I always like to let my big bus guests know how much we appreciate you being here, guys. Right. Y'all know what really helped put Vegas on the map, y'all. The we'll lights. Get you hitched in just a second right around here at the drive-through wedding chapel. One of the ones to our left here, the special memory wedding chapel. And when we make the next light, keep your eyes peeled on the left side. Might have to crane your neck back just a little because you're going to see the drive-up wedding window in just a second. Here we go. For about $85, if you and your sweetie $85? Just got that inclination and you just
there's
can't
no
wait.
Excuse.
You don't even gotta jump out of the car
to
jump
you.
That room, honey. All right. Especially what we'll say is compared to Las Vegas Boulevard, Fremont Street is a place to come hang out and party, y'all, because it's a spot where you can do half the walking, spend half the money, and have double the fun. But yes, what we also say as locals about Fremont Street, my friends, is that the freaks come out at night. And we're going to get a peek at them right about now.
We get the cameras out because we can't go back under. It's closed on the other side.
Thank you, Des.
No, honey, our stop is going to be just a few more minutes and we'll be able to get out once enough.
So, eyes peeled up above, you see the Viva Vegas light canopy and all the crowds out here to enjoy the party. If we see people doing the Slotzilla zip line up above us, they're about to set off right now from right to left. We're going to miss them. The Crown Speakeasy Bar at the Bob Museum. I highly suggest it if you like to dress up in that 1920s, 30s flapper Great Gatsby style. Get real fancy with it. You're going to want to go on their Instagram page for the Underground Bar to get the secret password and get let in. Do yourself some moonshine tasting over there at the Underground Bar. Now, straight ahead, we're coming up on the beautiful Main Street Station Casino Brewery Hotel. It is the oldest gambling hall in Las Vegas, my friends, since the 1900s. It's a beautiful New Orleans Bourbon Street theme, as you can see a little bit of that wrought iron balconies they have up top ahead. And once we make this next turn, keep your eyes peeled on the right, you'll see the beautiful bespoke stained glass windows that have been there since the 1900s as well. The ones that have survived, anyway. It's also one of the only places in Vegas you can still play those real live coin slots. You hear that clink, 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 pa-ching, pa-ching kind of noise when you put the money in, so.
You do that circus.
Circus still has some, right? There's a few places, but hey, this is definitely oldest. Definitely oldest over here at Main Street. Used to be known for one of the best buffets in Vegas as well, but always call ahead. That's Kay's best suggestion. Find out for sure the different buffets that used to be open. A lot of them have not opened back up, or they have restricted hours, so definitely worthwhile to check ahead. And up next, we're passing the brand spanking newest construction, the Circa, completed in 2020 over here on our left, guys. And it is the tallest building now in the Fremont Street area. The first new construction since the 1970s over here on Fremont Street. Circa is a 21 plus only resort and gambling establishment. They're home now to the world's largest sports book, as well as a huge indoor swimming pool party deck, 4 floors, and I'm sure they keep that party going. I heard about 3 out of the 4 have a swim-up bar fully stocked as well. One more peek at Fremont Street on the left as we pass one more time. See that beautiful Viva Vegas canopy. We'll be putting on the light and music show that you guys will have time to.
This casino, you could swim with. There's a shark tank. There's a pool. So if you stay here, you get to see the sharks.
I don't know, they're just having a vista. They just being noisy in the front of it. I don't know. Back there on the left side, y'all. I'm trying to see if one of them is wearing a bridal veil or something. Can't see them, but there's go. We're on the left, the world famous gold and silver pawn shop. We just passed the walk-up window where they will indeed give you 24/7 service. You just can't get in the building once the sun has gone down. Make sure they can reduce the concerns for some of the fools that like to hang out on these corners late night some of these days. Now, if anybody on the tour was interested in some of the spooky, haunted history of not just Las Vegas, but some of those other very unique, interesting serial killer stories and such throughout the U.S., we're going to be passing in just a moment here. When we make this next light, keep your eyes peeled on the left side. Over that darkened parking lot and past the liquor store, y'all are going to see a building lit up in red, all in red. That is the Zach Braggin Haunted Museum. So you can see a poster for it as we make this next intersection on your right for the Zach Braggin Haunted Museum. Guys, but on the left as we make this intersection, building all lit up in red is where the location is. Apparently, that building used to belong to a group that was a satanic cult. And that's why Zach Braggin decided that was the perfect spot to house all the creepy memorabilia, like the sunglasses that used to belong to serial killer Ted Bundy, I believe it is. And then they got the haunted doll in there, like the real life version of the movie Annabelle. You gotta follow the instructions if you're going in there, y'all. Make sure she don't put the whammy on you. You gotta say hello, goodbye, don't look her in the eye. Look, just don't tell them Kay sent you, because it's not Kay's cup of tea to have all that spooky stuff knowing my name. All right. But yes, we're going to be passing by the Thunderbird Lounge. Back in the days when people used to get together and do all that swing dancing, kind of social dancing was the norm. That was a classic spot. On the left, the little white chapel, the one with the Elvis swinging his hips. Looks like there's some folks over there making use of that little white chapel tonight. That was one of the most noteworthy on the tour of all the chapels we're passing by, because that's where Ben and J-Lo made it official. And back in the 90s, it was Britney Spears and her friends over there thinking they was just having a little fun, being silly, and had to get their actual real wedding annulled. Yes, it wasn't just a play wedding, y'all. It was real. Over there on the left, we're passing a building all in pink that says Coolsville Tattoo. It's one of a handful of locations for the $10 tattoos and piercings, if you're feeling so adventurous. My friends, there are 3 thrill rides up at the top of that 1,350-foot tall observation tower. We can see them lit up tonight. The tippy-tippy top spire is the Big Shot. There's one called the Insanity, and one known as the X-Scream. I already let y'all know a little bit about the sky jump, which is essentially the vertical zip line where people jump off the top or the side of that 1,300 foot tall tower and have about a 500 foot free fall, I should say, before they slow them down just a little bit so they don't go splat for the last 300 feet or so. Yes, okay. We're gonna peek our eyes to the right just about now to make sure we're not missing somebody doing the sky jump. Looking up at that blue platform, I don't think we're gonna catch them right now. No, it looks like it's not going on right now. Never hurts to check though. Now, If you ever wondered how much it costs to jump off the side of a building, my friends, well, some people say it ought to be free, but I don't think so, not if you want to survive it. So it's about $125 to do the sky jump. You know, another 20 bucks on top of that. They'll get you your commemorative photo of you peeing your pants on the way down. Out here in Vegas, my friends, you gotta let everybody know, spread it around. Birthdays, wedding anniversaries, kids moving out of the house, graduate of college, pay off your student loans. Free live circus acts every day at 11 a.m. And we have a fun tradition as we pass by the classic neon sign over here to the right. Our friend Lucky the Clown. Give him a wave, y'all. Give him a wave. Blow him a little bitty kiss. Mwah-mwah. That is meant to secure that Lady Luck from the inside. The entire time you're here with us in Vegas. Of course, their main valet area is a beautiful classic neon sign. It's been featured in a whole lot of classic, well, not classic, but Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. I don't know if we can call that a classic film. I was a 90s kid. I grew up during that era. Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me. Is it classic? No, but it was a fun one. And they did film over there, Circus. All right, next on the right, the brand spanking newest addition to the Las Vegas Boulevard skyline. Just opened in June of 2021, it is a collaboration between three major hotel resort families, the Conrads, the Crockfords, and the Hiltons. So nobody wanted to lose their shirt on the deal, they went in on it all together. We still have Katy Perry, I believe, doing her residency performances in their events arena.
And this is Gordon Ramsay Burger, that only me. And Yelly, know the price of
Runner Ramsey.
Come, Kathy.
Kathy is sad and upset and.
Well, you know, it's tired. It's been a mess, you know.
She's mad?
No, it's just been a mess all around at the end.
Vegas is crazy. A lot
Vegas is crazy.
Traffic.
Traffic is crazy. These people around me are crazy. Now. Yeah.
That's not bad. We can remove the egg.
Can't. Huh? You need to. You're the only one who doesn't know the price. See
ya. She's leaving. Are you drunk?
No. I haven't drank since, like, literally before.
Are you hungry? And tired.
Perfect. I will say that it's about $35. One concert? Oh, God.
Thank you for joining us on this segment on
Gordon. But we know we cannot only afford only $35 one burger, so we got Jack in the Box.
Yeah.
Not sponsored by anything, okay? Look at my hair, man. ¿Cómo está mi hair?
I don't like it. It's a mess right now. We're a mess, so too bad.
So, because there's only one burger that is $35, we had to get Jack in the Box because we know we're not gonna get food. It's 1:26 in the morning, and we have to get out of here at 11. I think I can manage. I don't know about Yelly. I think she's gonna be able to drive. She better drive. I've been driving all day. Well, I guess that's it.
Try the burger.
Oh, you want to try the burger? You don't want to try it first?
I don't like egg.
You want me to remove the egg before I bite it? Let's remove the egg. I know the egg is a very important part of the burger, but at this moment, the burger is cooked.
And it looks soft. When I was touching the bun, it was soft. Can you taste the truffle?
Oh, yeah.
We got the most expensive one, the truffle one.
And he never thinks of me.
I think it tastes better hot.
It's like when I'm on TV.
Actually, it tastes like the one that I used to eat in now. Yeah. It tastes like the one I used to eat over there in Chomps in Santa Monica.
I've had this before.
Have you heard of Chumps? I had it before.
You wash your hands?
Yeah, I wear my hands.
It's still good after like 2 hours of sitting.
Still good. Imagine hot.
Oh,
we removed the egg because we know Leo doesn't have the egg and that was
good. Let me cut my part.
Dice Yeli que eso se lo va a comer para breakfast tomorrow.
Let me cut my part.
That means it's a little dry.
Well, yeah, I was sitting for 2 hours.
It's still dry.
And you asked it for well done, so that's you. You asked for it well done, so.
Well done is dry?
Yeah.
I want to have a parasite on my stomach.
Why are you hanging to the egg?
That's true. You know, it's just a mess, man.
There
you go. Now you can have.
Oh, she wants to taste it with the egg.
No, I'm not saying.
You're gonna make a mess. I told
Ooh,
you.
Ooh, that yolk's still running.
I told you. Oh, wow.
Look, it's been sitting so long, you can see
Mama.
The fat.
It makes a big difference with the egg.
You can see the fat.
Really? It makes a big difference with the
Just sitting down.
You can see the fat. Jelly said it makes a big difference with the egg.
Okay. Oh, I got a taste of that blue cheese truffle butter. Mmm.
Tastes like bacon.
Oh, man. I got a good bite of like the truffle, the butter.
Yeah, actually, it does make a difference.
Gordon, 2 hours sitting. Three. It's still good.
Come in.
No, it's okay.
No, it's $35.
To be honest.
What's wrong with you?
I feel like I'm in post-concert depression. It's a real thing. It's not that I'm wrong with me, it's that she couldn't stop singing.
You're sleepy?
Yes.
I got a little bit of shaky hand because it's cold.
It's a 3 hour concert. 3 hours and 20 minutes.
Okay, how was the burger?
Bro, she did not stop singing.
How's the burger?
Y luego me sentaba.
And then she was like,
I guess that's a good. I need a poop. Here's a Jack in the Box.
It was a beating
all the way. I don't know if you want to say Jack in the Box, but here's a Jack in the
Box. Oh, I'm sorry. My burger review.
It's good.
There you go.
It's lit. And that's really, really good.
3 hours
Don't
sitting.
Don't you want to go to the bathroom?
Yeah.
It's 3 hours sitting?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Guess what?
It's a well done burger, Ramsey.
He's a loser.
What?
I know I should have put some buttermilk. A menos que no lo puse en el otro. No lo puse en el otro?
You didn't ask for buttermilk, I'll be honest.
It says like
they're
in the freaking thing
to butter beans. No, nothing. Thank you, Jack in the Box, for making our lives more miserable. I was gonna say something vile, but.
No, huh?
No.
No buttermilk.
Thank you, Jack in the Box.
What did you get?
I knew I should have gotten the jalapeno poppers.
No, but what did you get that they didn't give you?
Ranch.
We are going back home. Look at it's all desert. But I don't see no cactus. Mexican cactus, they're American cactus. Alright, so we are going to review. What are we going to review, Yelly? The hop off. Raelio. Is Gethys leaving?
No.
Hello, Gally.
Gally, how, well, where
we're gonna see your Taylor Swift experience.
Yes, so we actually came to Vegas because Kathy, I don't know if I'm actually pointing it right. Do we even see each other? I hope so, because
I think your finger is on the way.
You think my finger's on the way? There. Kathy wanted it to see, who you wanted it to see, Kathy?
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift. And she actually brought us along because she needed a car.
And Leo, it was Leo's first time in Las Vegas.
My real first time in Las Vegas.
In Las Vegas. What you thought about Vegas, Leo?
It's not for me. I'm not that party life like that.
You don't party?
I don't party. I don't gamble. I don't drink. I don't smoke. And, but it's a party lifestyle in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
It's not for me.
Me
neither. I don't like it either.
All right, lots of people. Yeah. So we did the tour bus, the big bus. Maybe we should start with the driver because the driver's
called. Oh, damn, look what happened over there, people.
Oh, look, I don't know what happened. Oh, there's a helicopter.
Oh, wow.
Look at it, look at that.
Emergency services.
Oh my God, I think somebody. If you call me the biggest, there's an accident.
Don't call me like.
Damn, look at that.
Oh, damn.
Who knows what happened?
Did they cry?
Hopefully they're safe. Yeah. Well, I don't. Hopefully.
It actually stopped.
Yeah, it's literally stopped. Maybe somebody, like. I don't know what could it be. Yo no vi ningún carro que estuviera.
Look at these clouds, too, people. Like, scary clouds.
It looks like it's raining, but at the same time it's not. I don't know what it is.
Did a tornado stop this entire? I feel sorry for whoever's going to Taylor Swift. Y'all gonna miss it.
Oh yeah, it is Saturday. She has another concert today,
yeah,
and
either
they decide to come today, well, they're probably gonna miss it. Kathy, say thank you because you didn't pass through this.
My finger, sorry.
Yelly, so what do you thought about the hop on, hop off?
I really like
Vegas?
It, because usually when you come to Vegas, you're like, oh my God, it's, you know, the casinos and only gambling and stuff like that. But I personally, not a gambler. I have such a bad luck on that. So I really like the museums, and we found out that there's more museums. Like, there's one if you like, you know, like back in the old days, there were like the mafia, stuff like that. There's a museum of the criminals in Las Vegas. It's really interesting. I like the fact that the person was live explaining to us all these tips and stuff like that. And she was raised and born in Las Vegas. And I liked it. I think it was better than New York.
Better than New York?
Yeah.
Because New York is only, it's a recorder, isn't it? I was preparing to get my my headsets, you know, my little hearing things to start hearing. What you thought, Leo?
I liked it. She really brought a lot of fun facts, like palm trees. The palm tree facts that every palm tree costs like $35,000 to like bring from Florida. Brought a lot of facts, a lot of her life stories, crazy life stories. We got the jokes. The jokes were funny. We got all the jokes. For me, it was my favorite one. It was my favorite one. My bus. That bus was pretty good.
Well, I like it. I like that.
She could have said any jokes she wanted because there was no kids on the bus.
Yeah,
so it was funnier.
Bus. Everybody was over 18, so she literally just made very funny jokes. I like that. Same thing. She was very informative. She was saying that it was best that a lot of locals don't go to the strip because, you know, there's a lot of tourists.
They avoided like the plague.
And
she says they avoided like the plague.
Yeah, and they overpriced the things. So she showed us where is the best places to eat, which you're gonna see in the tour, which is less expensive and you get more for your money. story facts about the casinos. And yeah, very informative. I like it too. I like it too. What else? It's hard to remember because it was last night.
it was just a little piece though. If you see the map is inside my bag. It's just a little piece that goes around Las Vegas.
I think Leo can show it.
When I saw it, I was like, what the hell? Like, you see the one from New York, and it takes you like all these places. You're like, what? But no, this one is just like a, like that, just like a
square.
Like a, not even a square, it's like a...
Well, Leo's gonna put the picture.
Yeah, you guys see it. It's like, and I was like...
It's a 2-hour tour, and we're like, how are you gonna be 2 hours?
But the reason why it's a 2-hour tour is because they give you 1-hour break.
Yeah.
You get a 1-hour break in the night. We don't know about the morning one. We need to go do that. We gotta do the morning one.
Yeah.
But the night one, they give you 1 hour in the Nugget. The Nugget Casino. One of the oldest casinos in all of Vegas.
Yes, which we noticed that the Nugget Casino has a pool with a big tank that has sharks. That was interesting. He also has a Chick-fil-A inside the casino. Just beware that it's closed on Sundays. Yeah.
I think you're covering the microphone.
Is Kathy going to talk about her concert?
Are you covering the microphone?
That's her concert right there.
You're not covering the microphone.
While we were working, Kathy was having fun.
Look. Oh my boy. I don't have words for it. I feel like I haven't seen her. I feel like it was a daydream.
Why?
Meaning I need to go to Los Angeles.
That's crazy. Well, you need to get an Uber. They just got married.
I'm gonna be married. If you see this video, I'm gonna sleep over here.
There's the haunted house.
Oh yeah.
In Las Vegas.
We're talking about Las Vegas.
Yeah.
It was owned by satanic people.
Because you don't have enough.
Made into a horror museum.
Yes.
So they said that museum has the doll where you cannot see their eyes. Like you cannot look directly to the eyes. Like you have to
have the devil's rocking chair.
Yeah.
It's very close from Las Vegas actually.
So that used to be a cult, and then like Leo's mentioned, it was a cult, and it was a satanic cult. They used to do rituals there and do all this stuff. And whoever bought it they decided to make it into like this museum where also they also have stuff, not only like the doll and the devil's rocking chair, but they also have criminals that what they used to use and stuff like that.
Yeah, they have a lot of artifacts. Hopefully we can do some other time when we come back to Vegas, we can record that.
Yes.
There is a in one of the casinos, the Flamingo Casino is another one. Casino has actually flamingos inside the casino. So, we were very short timing this time, but hopefully next time. There's also the lions. You can see the white tigers in the Mirage? I'll check. But there's some tigers inside there too that you can go and watch. And like a tiger habitat, I think they have it. One of the casinos, but I will check more onto that. I'll let you guys know when I Google it. And you also, if you don't want to get an actual helicopter ride, there is
a virtual reality one.
Exactly, like you can see the Vegas.
Also, you have Chris Angel. He's really famous for illusions and magic. He's not in the luxury hotel no more. Now he is in the Hollywood Planet.
He has his own theater though.
Yeah, he has his own theater.
Next to a strip club and a nightclub.
There's a Titanic Museum.
And the Titanic. The body exhibition.
Oh, there's also what we did in Hollywood, the Wax Museum. There's a Las Vegas Wax Museum.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of museums. If you guys don't like to But you're people like us that you guys don't like to gamble, party, nightclubbing. But you still want to enjoy Vegas. There's a lot of those
things. And the taco bar. So if you get, the taco bar has a chapel. So if you get married there, they give you a hot sauce bouquet.
It's called the Taco Bell Bar or Tequila one?
No, it's Taco Bell Bar.
It's a Taco Bell. It's a Taco Bell that has a chapel that you can get married there.
Yeah.
Hot sauce bouquet. How nice is that?
I was gonna buy it, but you gotta get married to, for them to give it to you.
Yeah. We have to wait until Kathy gets married.
Taco Bell.
Leo.
No, mine is gonna be in the drive-thru.
Oh, Leo, is that because she has children?
And it's cheaper, $35.
$35, and you don't have to even get out from the car. Oh dear, you're quick. All right, any last thoughts?
Oh, and the Chef Ramsay. I think I forgot to mention something about Chef Ramsay.
I'm gonna show them the bill.
We're gonna show you the bill, and damn it, I was gonna say something.
She forgot. Any last thoughts before her time comes back?
I forgot.
Leah, any last thoughts?
Oh, Chef Ramsay is free refills on lemonade. The lemonade is really good. I don't think we mentioned that. That the lemonade from
Helsinki. It tasted like Minute Maid with a little half of like real lemon.
I think it was really good though.
It was Minute Maid and a half a lemon squeezed in it. That's what it tasted like.
I still liked it. I really did. And they serve you really quick. Like they clean your plates, they bring your plates, they put your stuff. They're always attentive on once you finish a glass, they take that one out, they give you another one.
That's right.
Of water or
very good service.
Yeah.
Very good service. Especially the server, this service, right?
Yeah. Really
very good service. Kathy, any last thoughts?
I just went. I just came back. Oh. I still got assignments to do for my homework.
I think she got drunk. I really didn't.
It was just, this is the longest concert in my life
and
that I have
went to.
She's
still listening to Taylor Swift.
Look at that.
She's still listening to Taylor
Swift. So Taylor Swift, if you see her video, is one of your biggest fans.
Please, and shout out to them.
So please like and subscribe so we can make more of this content. If you have any suggestions for us, please let us know.
Eyes on the road, Yelly. Eyes on the road.
We do reviews and stuff like that, but we love tour buses. So if you want us to do a tour bus in another state or city, let us know.
Let us know.
For sure.
Yeah.
We'll do it.
We'll let it. We'll that waste your money.
Suggestions.
And we'll waste your money so you don't have to.
Did you say our thing wrong?
Well, we hope you really like this video and like and subscribe.
Follow us on our social media pages.
Instagram and TikTok.
Yeah, so we could make more of this content.
And give us any suggestions on any city you want to visit and don't want to spend money on city tour buses. We'll tell you if it's worth it or not.
Yes, because we'll waste our money so you don't have to. Is that the right?
Yeah.